Mendham family, and welcome back to another vlog. Today I'm actually going to be covering a really cool topic. Actually, it's been around for a long, long time, and some people have actually asked me multiple times in my lifetime, actually, of asking what's a great starter pet snake, actually, to start with, you know. And honestly, I tell them there's a few options out there, so I'm going to go ahead and cover the top five beginner pet snakes for you, starting with my girl, Ariel, my ghost corn snake. Now, typically, corn snakes, you guys, are known to be one of the most docile plastic colubrid snakes, actually, in the pet trade. As a matter of fact, corn snakes have actually been around for probably about 50 plus years in the pet trade. So, and the reason of that is because not only is because of their docile temper, but it's also, you can see, look at her pattern, you guys. Her color is very gorgeous. And of course, they come in a variety of different mutations, from albinos to snows to anurthoristics to motley corns. Totally different kinds of mutations of corn snakes out there. But and plus, corn snakes, normal corn snakes, you guys, they're actually pretty affordable. Usually about 20, 30 bucks a piece. So very affordable for a normal corn. But if you're looking to get something not just a normal, but maybe like a ghost corn, let's say, like Ariel here, they're probably going to be about $60 to $70 a piece. So a little bit pricey, but that's just how it is in the reptile community anyway. But I've had this girl for about 3 years now, so she's been a really great pet of mine. When I first got her, she did have a bit of a temper, but after several months of actually of handling her for a long time, she eventually became more docile and she warmed up to me. So I'm just glad now that she's a lot more chill than she used to be when she was younger. So this is a great starter pet snake if you guys want to get a corn snake. But there is a downside, though, that some people may not like about corn snakes, is that corn snakes are a type of rat snake, meaning that they eat rodents. So typically corn snakes are being fed mice throughout their life. As babies, they'll eat pinky mice, a sub-adult will eat usually small mice, and then a full-grown adult like Ariel here, they'll eat medium mice. So if you're looking for a snake, though, that's a great starter pet, but you don't want to feed a rodents, well, I got another option for you, so let's go ahead and check that one out next. You guys know that since it's October, we already are going into football season. We're actually, don't know what week we're in. I think we're into week 5 or 6 right now of the NFL. So I want to actually give a huge shout out to EA Sports, you know, a brand new app that actually just came out just a couple of months ago called Madden NFL 21 Mobile. Actually, believe it or not, I have been playing Madden Mobile for the last several years, believe it or not, since middle school. And believe it or not, just this past fall, EA just announced they would be launching a brand new app, actually, that would be kind of like the next generation of Madden Mobile. Unfortunately, their original app, they have discontinued it because really they didn't really add anything new to it. But now, actually, believe it or not, with Madden Mobile 21 actually now officially launched, it's actually pretty cool, believe it or not, because I can actually, not only can I just do other new features on Madden Mobile, but also I can customize my own avatar now, which is super duper cool, you guys. We have been waiting for this for the last few years on Madden Mobile, and believe it or not, EA, I guess, they thought they were going to be able to do it for a couple years ago. They never had a chance, but now finally with Madden Mobile 21, we can finally do that. So I'm just going to go ahead actually and show you guys some of the graphics to see how good it really is. I hope you guys actually enjoy this game, so I highly recommend go ahead and download it if you guys really love football. Link is going to be down in the description to download it, you guys. So, and yes, the app is free, doesn't cost any money whatsoever. Go ahead and download it if you want. Whether you have the App Store or Google Play Store, go ahead and download Madden Mobile 21. I hope you guys enjoy it. So let's go ahead and get back into this video. So another snake that could be a great beginner for most young kids, especially when I was young, is also, of course, garter snakes here, you guys. Now this one, of course, you guys know it's Tyson, my albino checkered garter snake, and I've had him for the last close to about almost 3.5 years now, and literally he actually just came out of shed this morning. So, and he did make a little mess in the cage, but I cleaned that up earlier, so he's all good to go. But he's a little bit ornery today. So now, believe it or not, garter snakes are part of also the colubrid family, but they're also, their other Latin name is Samnophis sertalis. But these guys, believe it or not, are a checkered garter snake native to the southwestern part of the U.S. and found in northern Mexico. And these guys are actually one of the few species of garter snakes that you will see quite often in the pet trade. And also, they do have normal checkered garters that actually are pretty interesting looking as well. And I may have mentioned this in the vlog a while back. I'm actually looking for a female albino checkered garter, so if you guys know anyone that has one, feel free to private message me on my Instagram. I have it down in the link in the description if you guys want to go ahead and message me on there. So anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and use this snake hook because he doesn't like to be handled a whole lot. He's quite squirmy about it, so I'm just going to go with the snake hook instead. Oh, yep, you're all right, bud. Yeah, you can see he's kind of like flattening out a little bit. That's a defense mechanism to make himself look a little bit bigger, so I just don't want to stress him out too much. Now, believe it or not, there are dozens of different species of garter snakes found throughout much of North America, from all the way from Canada to the U.S. and parts of Mexico. And believe it or not, the most common snake species we find here in Michigan are the eastern garters, the butlers, and the northern ribbon snakes, basically. But there's probably about 50 different species in total, somewhere around that marker. But really, there are only several different species of garters that are in the pet trade now in the reptile community. But every year, we're getting new ones in here, like California red-sided garters. They're starting to become very, very popular, and they're actually pretty looking, too, I'm not going to lie. There's also Santa Cruz garters. We got Plains garter snakes as well. There's also Lake Chapala garters, if that's how it's pronounced. If I pronounce it wrong, let me know how it's actually pronounced. But anyway, so yeah, this is actually just a male albino, but yeah, like I said, I'm looking for a female, so. But these guys are actually great pet starter snakes as well, and this was actually my very first kind of pet snake, to be totally honest with you. If you guys remember when I first started doing YouTube, I did have a wild-caught eastern garter named Cody, who unfortunately passed away about almost 2 years ago already. And listen, I still miss him very much, but that was just part of nature, I guess, you know, so. Anyway, but since Tyson's an albino, he cannot survive in the wild because he was also born in captivity. So in captivity, these guys probably wouldn't survive as much as compared to a wild individual. And of course, in captivity, there's different diseases that are not usually out in the wild. So anyway, so garter snakes. These guys are one of the few species actually in the reptile pet trade that you can actually find them in pet shops, like I said, but you also don't have to feed them rodents. If you guys want a pet snake that you don't want to feed mice or rats to, these guys will actually eat different things like earthworms and small fish, like a little bit of sushi. Sometimes we feed them minnows as well a few times, as believe it or not, we also have to feed them rodents here a little bit too, because I actually just start transferring my garters, just started eating rodents, because rodents actually contain some nutrition for them actually, so that helps them actually have a quick growth spurt, actually allow them to grow faster. So that's why you guys can tell this guy, he's a little chunky, but I don't like to overfeed him. That's one thing you definitely don't want to do. So if you guys are looking for a snake that you don't want to feed rodents to, garter snakes are probably your best option out there, and I do highly recommend them. It depends on the species what you want. If you're looking for something that you don't want, let's say an albino checker garter, you can go ahead and look for different species online. Anyway, there's like I said, California red-sided, there's plains garters, there's even normal checker garters if you guys want to go ahead and look for some there. So let me know in the comments below if you guys are interested in purchasing a garter, if that's what you think. So if not, well, there's still a couple more options out there. So let's go ahead and move on to the next one. So now number three, you guys, on what a good beginner snake would be for young people is ball pythons. Now, believe it or not, you guys know, though, Ellie, ooh, yeah, she's a little feisty today. Come here, girl. Come on, girl. Come on. Yeah, I guess you can hang on your plant then. All right. Hi, honey. Yeah, like as I was saying, you guys, you know Ellie is not a ball python, but she's still a great beginner snake for me personally, because she's so small, she's got a pretty good temper, and she doesn't have to eat large rodents. But ball pythons, anyway, you guys, is that they're a great beginner snake. They're like Ellie here, you guys. They have a pretty docile temper. They're not that ornery and aggressive, and also they just don't get too big. You know, ball pythons get about 3-4 foot long. Even though Ellie is not, like I said, not a ball python, they are still part of the Pythonidae family. So anyway, ball pythons have been around in the pet trade for like 50 years, about as long as corn snakes, believe it or not. And they're actually considered the best beginner pet snake because they're so docile and very gentle. But they come in also cool different paint jobs as well. They come in so many different morphs, from albinos to aneurytheristics to clown ball pythons to pastels, all that kind of stuff. Anyway, it's just so really cool that they come in a variety of different colors, and they're also pretty affordable. A normal ball python can actually go about $30 a piece, which is pretty affordable, to be totally honest with you. But when you compare that to an albino, they can be a bit pricey, around 150 to 200 bucks a piece. But really, ball pythons, like I said, are just a very gentle snake. I actually thought about getting one as my first pet snake before I ever got my garter snake, so my mom unfortunately turned that down because I was really young, only like 11 years old at the time. But oh, yep, you're gonna say hi? I know, you like to say hi to the people up there. I know. But yeah, like I said, ball pythons, you guys, they're pretty docile. You can see Ellie here is a pretty curious animal, of course. And ball pythons sometimes do like to climb as well. That's why she was trying to come up to the camera. She actually wanted to climb onto it. But ball pythons, I think, you guys, they don't need a vertical cage like this, for example. Ball pythons at times will stay on the ground. So I would recommend like a cage like my girl Ariel has. Usually a 20-gallon tank would be a good starter, in my opinion, for a young ball python. And then eventually upgrade them to a 40-gallon ball. To a 40-gallon tank. I was going to say 40-gallon ball python. I was going to say that's a big fat ball python. But believe it or not, though, ball pythons have a very long lifespan, you guys. Some could last, I've been heard to be lasting 30 to 40 years in captivity. I think there's even one in the St. Louis Zoo, believe it or not, that just produced a clutch of eggs at the age of 47, actually not too long ago, which I was just blown away by that age, you guys, especially the eggs as well. I don't know if they were fertile or not, but anyway, I just wanted to cover on that topic there on ball pythons because they are super duper cool. But like I said, you guys, I said that more than once, Ellie is not a ball python. She's a children's python. But really, like ball pythons, children's pythons are a great starter snake too. If you don't want a python that gets too big, you can get a children's python. But anyway, like I said, ball pythons, one of the top five best beginner snakes in the book. So, but if you can't afford a ball, if you don't want to get a ball python, you can get a children's python if you want. And number four, actually, on the list of the top five beginner snakes, you guys, is another really cool one. It's called the rosy boa. Now, believe it or not, when I was a little kid, the first time I ever saw a rosy boa in a snake book, I actually really was interested in getting one. But unfortunately, the local pet store here in town doesn't sell rosy boas. Hell, they only have maybe one or two different snake species they sell for sale, and one of them is ball pythons. Which, don't get me wrong, I've said that actually earlier, ball pythons are one of the best starter pet snakes. Unfortunately though, the ones in the local pet store here in town, they're a bit kind of pricey, maybe like $60, $70 a piece, just for a little baby ball python. But anyway, rosy boas. Rosy boas are actually also considered a great beginner pet snake, because one thing is for sure, it's actually because of their size, they stay very small, about 2-3 feet long, and only about... They only don't need really a big enclosure. Basically, it's about the size of Lucy's cage here, maybe like a 10-15 gallon enclosure at max for a rosy boa, because these guys, like I said, can only get 2-3 feet long, and they also tolerate being handled very, very well, kind of like corn snakes and ball pythons. And they're actually not too hard to feed as well. They're mostly small rodent eaters. Usually they'll eat small mice, usually at max, maybe even small pinky rats, you know, all that kind of stuff. So, even though I don't have any rosy boas or rubber boas either, rubber boa, that's a different species that's also native here to the U.S., believe it or not. We're not going to talk about rubber boas, though. Rosy boas, though, unfortunately, here in Michigan, they're not very often for sale too often. I guess, I just don't know why, but regardless of the price of them is also very cool. Very good as well. Usually you can find one actually that a non-locality one, just like a normal rosy boa, just a plain normal one, can be worth $25-$30 a piece, which is super duper affordable. So if you guys are looking for a boa actually for a beginner, rosy boas are definitely the beginner one you actually want to start with for sure. And last but not least of the top five snakes, you guys, is king snakes. Generally California king snakes, I should say, because they're actually probably the most common subspecies of the common king snakes that you'll find in pet shops actually, and of course at reptile vendors and stuff there as well. And believe it or not, king snakes don't really require too much actually for their enclosures as well, in supplements and pet care as well. And king snakes range about maybe 3 to about 4 feet max actually, to be totally honest with you. And they have a pretty cool docile temper as well, just like the other beginner snakes up there, what we've had discussed over. And of course, king snakes are like rat snakes. They're rodent eaters basically, and actually at times cow kings actually, believe it or not, will eat other snakes. And that's why they call them king snakes in general, is because king snakes actually will eat other snake species. Even rattlesnakes in the wild has been recorded as well. So you don't actually get to see it too often, but it's actually pretty cool when you get to see a king snake eat a venomous rattlesnake of any species of that sort. So with that said, I think that's all the snake species that we've covered, if I didn't miss any, but I hope I didn't anyway. So let me know in the comments below, which of those top five beginner pet snakes do you guys want to start with? And if you guys are interested in purchasing that kind of snake species, do some research online and on different reptile shops out there, whether it's like DHB, Snakes at Sunset, or even like Triple L Reptile, for example, there as well. They do sell garter snakes actually online. on the sites as well. There's also a website called Morph Market, actually, that I've done research on, like, where people actually, different breeders across the country, they will put garter snakes up for sale there, and actually will sell them, like, different species, all sorts of stuff. So, anyway, with that being said, that's all the snake species we all have to cover for today. So if you guys are looking for a beginner snake out there, you want to start with, whether it's for a little kid, or if you're just starting to get into reptiles, make sure the exact snake you're looking for is, you got to do your research before you purchase this animal, including the supplies, the temperature, lighting, water bowl size, and also bedding and substrate, all that as well. So regardless though, if you guys enjoyed this video, feel free to hit that like button for me and turn on the notification bell on my channel. Hit that subscribe button if you do that for me, please. And I promise you guys, I'm gonna see you guys next time.